Hello everyone, this is SushAmita here. Thanks a lot for all the support you have shown so far. I am really glad that we have been able to reach more than 6,200 people currently. And I've been following all the comments which you have been posting in the YouTube channel, and I'm really thankful for that. And also I'm glad that Support Vitiligo is able to cater to your questions, needs to the best possible. And if there was some delay in answering your questions or answers, then I'm sorry for that too. So we do our best. I try my best to answer to all your comments and queries through various mediums. So we'll continue doing that this year as well, to the best of our possibilities. So now, today I would like to focus on one topic which many people have been asking me for quite a while now. So I have discussed earlier also, I keep getting emails, messages, comments through various social media handles, YouTube being one of the major ones. So in that, also people say that they are under a lot of stress and a lot of pressure. It can be emotional, mental, etc., right, from various sources. And vitiligo also plays a role in that. So before we go ahead, I just wanted to ask you one question. I want you to be to think whatever I'm asking now. I want you to think over it for the remaining few minutes. So when we have a cut or a wound, then what do? Do we let it be, or do we heal it? Or else we do something to heal it? For example, we may reach out to first aid, or we use band-aid or any such things, right? Or if it is too much, then we may reach out to a professional doctor as well, right? Those are the things which we generally do when we are not well. It can be a fever, it can be a cut or a wound, etc. At the same time, when we are very disturbed mentally or emotionally, when we have too many thoughts, or when there is a lot of pressure from outside, it can be through people, situations, etc. In such cases, what do we do? Do we do anything for that? I want everybody watching this to think to themselves, do you do anything for that? Or do you just let it be? And maybe what happens when we let it be? Over a period of time, what happens? It piles up as anger, frustration, anxiety, and then it comes out in various ways, right? It comes out as reactions, mostly at our homes, or maybe as at times outside also. So what do we do for this? Yeah, I wanted you to think. So you know, I can give you my example. So this is just a casual video speaking about my own experiences, because I feel that we all are in different levels of our lives, and maybe sharing experiences can also help at times. Maybe I'm not an expert, but yes, I can definitely share my experiences and how some things helped me. So if you see, to start with, I got vitiligo when I was a kid of around 9 years old. So that time, there's no idea, none of us knew what vitiligo was or how important mental health is, how it impacts emotions, nothing. So like many of you, even I have faced comments, I have faced criticism for various things. There have been stigma also. I have seen other children, as in my teens especially, I have seen children who were scared of looking at my face or my hands, my patches. So, maybe sometimes I even cried for those reasons. And also, most of the times we feel helpless, right? What can we do to overcome all this? So all those moments, it was very difficult, if you see. And in such an age, you don't even know that how you can help yourself. And at that point of time, there was not much awareness about vitiligo or mental or emotional health. But then slowly as I grew up, I noticed, all these emotions were slowly reflecting on the person I'm becoming. It can be in terms of confidence, it can be in terms of reactions, the way I am. So then slowly I started looking into things, how I can help myself. So one of the things which I did was expressing it out. So initially, like, you make many of you might be able to relate to me. Like, when somebody asks about vitiligo or about how it is, then some of us might be reserved. That no, it's like it's my personal life and I don't want to share about it. It's okay. It's okay not to. It's okay to be reserved. But at the same time, like, over a point of time, I realized that when I started speaking for myself, that is, self-advocacy is the term we use. So when I started doing that, it actually helped me a lot. It gave me a freedom of speech, like, that expression that I, like, whichever was suppressed inside, it just came out in a good manner. So whenever people asked about vitiligo, I explained what it is. And that way, if you see the system, like, if you see the support system or any, like, the social circles around me, were pretty well sensitized. And they didn't bother, because, you know, 90% of them are just curious. And when you address them in a friendly manner, it becomes okay. And remaining 10%, where you feel that the comments are not stopping, you can't do much about it. You can just let it be. So that's why, like, surrounding ourselves with people who actually lift us up, who actually at least understand, it helps a lot. And at the same time, people who may not understand us for any of the reasons, then you can just let it be, let it go. That's it. Like, in some cases, it's very difficult when, like those comments come from a very close circle. Like it can be from a family or anybody else. This I'm telling in general. It can be in your case also. So that time, you can try acknowledging it, speaking it out. And even if speaking doesn't help, then we just let it be. Like, we do our best and we help ourselves, because we can't change anybody, right? So the only thing is how we respond to things at times help a lot. So over a period of time, how I, like, started taking things, started responding to people, things helped me a lot. And even in these cases, like, some habits, like, for example, diverting my mind in doing various things which I liked. For example, it can be something like cycling, swimming. Like, swimming depends on how it suits your skin, and also, like, some things like yoga, meditation. Like, meditation is part of yoga. So any such thing, and also, like, if you see, there are many other life hacks which you can use to help yourself. Even reading can help a lot. Now you have many formats of reading also. Like, it can be a hard copy, Kindle, or it can be even audiobooks like Audible. Like, they are amazing companions. And you get a lot of self-help books also. So I'm not going to mention anything in specific, because I want you to explore on your own. Like, what might help you? You pick anything, any of the things which you feel helps you. It can be art, it can be dance, music. Just see. Or also, it can be speaking to somebody, or it can be writing down your emotions. It can be any such thing. So just see what suits you. And also, like, there are support groups which you can join. For example, even as part of Support Vitiligo, we have a support network where we have people with vitiligo who are part of it. So if you're not part of any network, if you don't have any such support system, then you can definitely join us. The details are in the description. So that way you can also be part of us. So you can be like part of a community which is conducive. And also feel free, like, whenever you feel like something is not suiting your way of thinking, or it's uncomfortable to you, then be okay to walk out. Even like in our support group, if something like some person doesn't like something, then we're open to it. We'll be like, okay, if you want to leave, you can. So just that understanding of, like, what is okay for you, do that. There are also some mental and emotional hacks called as self-talk, affirmations. So in my case, how it has helped me is, like, for example, like right from the beginning, like, it can be during our childhood days or even now, we keep on getting inputs from many people, right, including our own thought process. So it can be through our family circle, other social circles like friends, or it can be colleagues, or it can be anybody outside. So it's very organic, right? On a daily basis, we get many inputs. But over a point of time, what might happen is, like, these inputs may become our beliefs. Like, for example, maybe as a child, we would have heard from an elder. It can be a parent or a teacher or anybody, that, like, we, like, you're not good enough, or like you will be only this much. Then like we keep believing it maybe, and then it also restricts us from being our best, right? And also you can take in case of vitiligo, like we are told that we look a certain way, that like maybe also in some cases we were told that like we are not that good looking or something. But as we grew up, we also realized that looks are not just appearances, right? It's also how we project ourselves. So all these limiting beliefs which we gather as a child or as a teen or over a period of time, even after we grow up, so these things can be replaced. These thoughts can be replaced by somebody like some other thought which is more positive. Because we need to think, like, the thoughts which we already carry, is it an opinion or a fact? When you actually differentiate, then you'll find out that most of them are opinions of others and it's not us. It's not a fact. So that time we need to consciously replace it. Something like, I know I'm good enough. Like, I know what I am. We all are like good in some or the other ways, right? So we need to consciously replace these thoughts. And in such cases, like changing our self-talk. Self-talk is something like what runs in our mind. Like sometimes when we face a problem, then we'll be like, ah no, like this, my life will be like this. It will be like this only. It may not change. That is the time when we need to change thinking that no, there can be a change. Like no, I can actually at least try towards bringing in a change. So when we change that, when we shift that thought process, then it helps a lot. So in such cases, if you see affirmations which start with I am, I can, etc., can help a lot. So as part of support vitiligo, like since I'm a believer of affirmations always, so I had come up with something called Vitiligo Hacks. So in which like we feature a person with vitiligo along with a positive affirmation, like which helps like same thing, like affirmations help in mental programming, right? Reprogramming of the mind thoughts. So that is one thing. You can follow us also on our Instagram and Facebook handles, which will have these affirmations. So that is one part. And also the final thing is, if you think like none of these things are helping, or if you're going through something very severe, it can be grief, losing a loved one, that is, and also it can be abuse or any such thing, then approach a professional who can help you out. Approach a professional system, because that helps a lot. And the most important thing is, the one person who can help us is we ourselves. We have to raise that voice, like we have to stand for ourselves, because only that, when we take that first step, is when others can take the remaining steps. So please help yourself first. Yeah. And the same thing, like if there is anything you would like to share, or if there is anything you like to express, then please post in the comment section also. And yeah, I'll be writing some blogs also, which will be on our website, which is www.supportvitiligo.org, which you will find in few months time. Until then, I would ask you to follow our social media handles on Facebook, Instagram, etc., in which you can keep track of the latest updates. Yeah, thanks a lot and take care. Like, a healthy mind actually leads to a healthy body and overall lifestyle. So please do take care.